I was pretty excited when I found out that Python is one of the most popular languages for data science. Admittedly, though, I was a little bit nervous when Francesca mentioned Jupyter Notebooks. I didn't have much experience with those. I was thrilled when I found out that VS Code, my favorite editor, has packages and extensions for Python, Jupyter Notebooks, and Azure Machine Learning. I think I'll feel right at home because I'll be in my Visual Studio Code environment. So let's get our local environment set up, and hopefully you'll feel comfortable in VS Code too. As always, there's additional documentation both on the screen and linked in the description down below. Let's get started. We need to download and install three things: Visual Studio Code, Python, and Anaconda. I'm going to verify that I have Python installed in my Anaconda prompt. That's looking good. Next, I'm going to create an Anaconda environment. I'm going to take the advice from the Visual Studio Code team and create an environment ready for data science. I'm going to call this environment dev intro DS. I'm going to specify version 3.7 for Python, and I'm going to also install pandas, Jupyter, Seaborn, scikit-learn, Keras, and TensorFlow. Some of the most popular tools for data science. Once the Anaconda environment has been created, we can activate it with conda activate and the name of our environment. Next, we want to install Azure ML SDK. I'm going to specify two parameters here, the AutoML and explain features, which will really help with some of those advanced topics that Francesca will lead us through later on. And we also want to make sure that we have access to the AutoML training tools. So I'll go ahead and install that as well. Okay, I think our environment is set up. Now we should set up Visual Studio Code. There are three extensions we need. Head over to the extension marketplace and install the Python extension, the Azure account extension, which will allow us to sign in to Azure within Visual Studio Code, and the Azure Machine Learning extension. Once we have all three of those installed, we can verify that everything is working inside of Visual Studio Code. First, I want to sign into Azure. I'll open up the command palette and choose Azure Sign In. This will open up a new browser tab and allow me to sign into Azure through the browser. Notice, since I've already signed into the Azure portal in another tab, it's just a quick click of a button. Now you can see that I'm signed into Azure down here at the bottom of VS Code. Before getting started, I already created a folder where all of this code is going to be stored. It's called Dev Intro Data Science. Now I'm going to create a new file, and we're going to call this bikeshare.ipynb. This will create a new Jupyter Notebook file. Because we've installed the Python extension and we've installed Jupyter through our Anaconda environment, VS Code will automatically convert this file into a Jupyter Notebook interface. There's a few things to notice to make sure that they're correct. One is that VS Code is referring to the right Python. Down here at the bottom left of your VS Code window, you should be able to see the correct version of Python. And if you hover over it, you should be able to see that this is using the Anaconda environment that we just created. Next, you should make sure that your Jupyter kernel is also set to that same Python version in that same Anaconda environment. Now your local environment is all set up.